Hey everybody, it's PhoenixTalon, and we're here to do another tutorial video. This is actually an add-on video to my Minecraft multiplayer server to single-player game conversion, whatever you want to call it, which, you guys are amazing. That video's got over 60,000 views as I'm recording this, which thank you so much. That was just a impromptu video where I said, hey, let's do this thing real quick, and it's exploded, so thank you. But I keep getting these really common questions, which is good. I'm glad you guys are asking questions. So I'm going to try to answer at least one of those. The big one that I always get is somebody says, incidentally, I'm going to timestamp each one of these sections. So if you don't want to listen to me ramble on about what this video is about, just skip to the section called NBT Explorer or get NBT Explorer, and that's going to be the meat of this video, assuming that all these other conditions are met. So here are those conditions. So this is going to assume that you've already got a single player vanilla. This is only going to work for vanilla and with no plugins and no mods. Plugins maybe might carry over, but that's not what this is about. So it's going to be, you had a single player game, you converted it over to a multiplayer game on a server, you know, and then you want to convert it back to a normal single player game. This is not, okay, I was single player, I opened it up to LAN, we all played together, I'm back in single player. No. This is, I was single player, created the game, changed it over to a server. Lots of people were playing on it, hosted on like Bisect or Apex or whoever, you know, MC Pro Host, whoever you host with. Then you convert it back to single player, and then, you know, following my tutorial video or somebody else's, and you said, wait, where is all my stuff from the multiplayer game? I'm starting, I spawned back into my single player world with all of my single player gear. That's what this is about. I can fix that for you. I can actually show you. It is a complicated process. It is not simple. Okay, so this is a little more advanced and it's going to make some assumptions. This is, video is going to assume a couple of things. One, that you already have that single player to multiplayer back to single player, okay? The other thing this is going to assume is that you've got a little bit of knowledge and you're comfortable working with third-party programs. I don't usually like to use third-party software in a tutorial video because that may not be something you want to download on your system. If you want to continue with this video though, you're going to need to get it, and I'll get to that part of the video when we get there. So if that's going to be a problem for you, then don't watch this anymore. And that is the only way that you can fix this, by the way. So if you want to get it fixed, this is it. Now going into this more, we're going to go ahead and I'm going to go through the process of making a single player game, making a server, going back to the single player game, just so you can see the process. I'm not going to go in depth with it, but I want you to see that it does work. So if you trust me, you know it's going to work. Go ahead and skip ahead to the appropriate section for NBT Explorer. If you just want to see it work and what the process is kind of done quickly, then we'll get into that. Okay, so I think that's enough introduction. Again, thank you so much for the big responses that we've gotten, and I really appreciate you guys giving me the support. So let's go ahead and keep going, and the first thing we're going to do is open Minecraft. Let's make a single player game. So with this video, I've tried to zoom in a little bit, so I'm going to be switching between the Minecraft game and the desktop and all that stuff just to try to make it easy for everybody so we can see what's going on. So we're going to make a world here. We're going to create a new world, and we're just going to call it Best World, okay? Because everything we do in Minecraft is our own best world. So all of your worlds should be your best. I am going to allow cheats. No, I'm not. There we go. I mean, I'm going to allow cheats, and the reason that I'm going to allow cheats is so that we can get some items real quick. Normally, this doesn't have an impact on your server. As you guys know, you have to OP your users and stuff like that, make them operators. The only thing that really matters is what your game mode is that will transfer from single to the server and then back again. As I'm going to show you, I'm going to go ahead and do that with the game mode, playing around with it so you can see what all those changes will be. I don't need to change any settings, don't care what the seed is. We're just going to spawn in, and it doesn't matter. But yes, I don't want to oversimplify too much. This is kind of not, it's not a one-size-fits-all, again, because of mods, because of plugins, because of specific things to your world, but it should be a one-size-fits-most. And this is actually really yeah, whatever. All right, so let's go ahead and we're going to change our game mode to creative. We're going to grab a few things. We're going to do this. Maybe a grass block. All right, I think this is fine. I don't want to wander too far from spawn because in the server, what's going to happen, I'm going to get some obsidian so we can go to the nether. I want to show you that that works too. I don't want you to think that the nether, like this is only going to work for Overworld. I'm going to show you how to make this work for the nether too, okay? So, and the end, you can follow the same process for the end. We're already on fire. Oh my goodness. Okay, so just while we're here, because I'm feeling kind of silly, let's make like a reverse tree. So we know we were here. And I think spawn was like literally right here, so that might be tough. All right, let's jump in. And this is... Yeah. Oh, it's a good thing I'm in creative. We would have died instantly. So let's put a couple of things here. We'll do another tree here. A reverse tree. Do the reverse tree because it's not natural and that could never happen. So we're going to go back. It's not important. It's just so that we can show that all this is, in fact, going to work. Where did I put the... There it is. I was like, where's my reverse tree? Okay. So we're going to go ahead and cancel out of this. So we're done in here for the moment, Okay. So there we go. We're going to close that. Not close, minimize. All right. And we're going to turn that off so you guys can see the desktop. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make a Minecraft server real fast. So I'm doing it with a paper server, just something I'm familiar with. You can do whatever you want. It's just your standard batch file. There's 100 videos on how to make a server. Follow the one that works best for you. It does its thing. It, you know, makes some files over here. You change your settings. You run it again. There's a process to it. I am not going to get in depth with it. Depending on the server you're making, this could be totally different. It does not matter because the process is going to be the same. So you get your EULA, your end user license agreement, change that to true, save, close server properties. We're going to call this, where are you, level name, there you are. We're going to call this best world. At this point, you don't have to call it that necessarily, but you should. When we convert back, you definitely want to. But this part, you get away with it. All right. So that should have done that. I've closed the server. I'm redoing the server. This is going to make all the server files right here. You're going to see the whole world pop in. And that's fine. And then what we're going to do... And there we go. There we go. Okay, cool. Now, what we're going to do... is jump into multiplayer. And just real quick, just to show you that I'm making a multiplayer game, I'm going to add server. We're going to call it Best World. Actually, you're not going to call it Best World because you can call this anything you want, which I know it sounds weird, but I'm going to call it anything you want. The reason for that is, and then I'm going to put in my IPv4 address. I don't want you guys to see that. Not that I think it matters, but just in case. So we've called it anything you want here. Let me do this the right way there. All right. And, it doesn't matter what you name it in your Minecraft, game. This one, it matters on the server side. Look at this icy cold spawn. That's great. All right. Disconnect, get out of there. All right. Cancel and close that out or minimize that. Okay. Then we're going to tell the server to stop. All right, server is off. And now we're going to go to our save folder and our Minecraft save folder, our single player game saves. Boom, boom. Okay, so on one side we've got our server, and on the other side, if I can fit these in the window. All right, there. Here, you know what? I'm just going to make these a little smaller so you guys can see what is going on here. There we go. Excuse me. So right here at the top, we've got our server files for the world, right? And in here, we go into best world, and we've got our dimensions, okay? So what we want to do is go ahead and delete everything that's in here. So we're going to delete all these things. Be careful when you're deleting things. Make sure you're deleting one and not the other. Make sure, in this case, you're deleting your server files right now, because if you delete your single player game, then yeah, then you're done. Like, literally, you're done. There's nothing you can do. So we're going to copy everything here except for three things. We're not going to copy our dimension one. We're not going to copy dimension negative one. And we're not going to copy the icon. Incidentally, if you don't know what your dimensions are, we figured those out earlier. Dimension zero is the overworld. Dimension negative one is the nether. And dimension one is the end. Okay, so if you need that information, that's good knowledge. Oh, and I also don't want to drag them over. That's important. I want to copy and then paste, okay? Because I don't want to move these folders depending on where your save files are. I just want to copy them over. So that's all that stuff. Now we're going to come in here to the nether. We're going to delete all this. And then we're going to go over here and copy dimension one and paste that. Then we're going to go in the end, get rid of these. So we did dimension negative one. Now we're doing dimension one. Copy, paste. All right. So we should have nether, end, and our main world file. Okay. So that's all you need to make that work. So we're going to go ahead and do our run.bat. And that's going to open our server again. And then we're going to go ahead and minimize these for the moment, just to get them out of the way. We're going to go ahead and turn on our Minecraft game. There we go. And we're going to go into our multiplayer now, right here, our anything you want server, and see if we are actually doing what we're supposed to be doing. Hey, look at that. We're right there. Remember what I said. The server is going to spawn you wherever it wants you to, so, or wherever it wants to. So, yeah. Also, if you'll notice, I'm still in creative mode, even though I'm not OP'd, right? So that's important. I'm not OP'd, and I'm still in creative, because I was in creative in the single-player world. That's why, okay? So now, we'll come over here. We've got our reverse tree. And now, just to be silly, just to be fun, let's grab something that has no business being in the nether, like, I don't know, a sponge block, all right? And we're going to put some sponges in here. I don't know. I'm just, whatever, right? You know, that's fine. Then we're going to go back through the overworld. And because we have sponges, let's go ahead and use them. All right, they're sponges. And now what I want to do is give myself a bunch of obsidian and a bunch of sponges, and then we're going to get rid of all these things, okay? And then I'm thinking, let's give ourselves a full set of netherite armor. Boom! Look at that. Yeah. Okay? So that's our full set of netherite armor. And now what we're going to do is I'm going to OP myself on the server, okay? So I'm going to OP PhoenixTalon 42. All right, so I'm now OP. So now I can change back to survival, okay? So we're in survival. Everything's fine. All the things are good. And we're going to leave this world, okay? So some things to keep in mind. Just think before I leave the world. Notice, I got a stack of obsidian, a stack of sponges, and a full set of netherite, and I'm in survival. Okay, this is important. This matters. All right, we're going to cancel that, and we're going to just minimize that back down. And then we're going to stop the server. Okay, so server is stopped. The command I'm using is stop. Literally, it's that easy, guys. Don't make this any harder than we have to. So now, we need to convert this back to a single player world, okay? And you can do this a couple of ways. The first way I'm going to do, though, or the way that I prefer to do, is I am going to, not that one, this one. I'm going to go into my save folder again, and I have best world here. Now, I can delete it from the Minecraft game, or I can delete it from here. It does not matter, but I am going to delete it from here, okay? And now my game is deleted. So now we've got a clean save folder here, you know, that now we can save too. And just to show you that, let's go back into Minecraft. And you look in the single player game, there's no best world. Okay, so we're going to create a brand new world that we're also going to call best world, because that is our server name. And we're just trying to keep this all very simple. Allow cheats is going to be back on so that we can have some cheaty stuff in case we need it. And create new world. Create new world. I'm sorry about the singing. I apologize. I won't sing again. Promise. So what we're doing now is basically the bulk of what is in my tutorial that I've made prior to this. Okay, so obviously this is not where we were at before, right? There's no fire, there's no lava, there's no things. Not our thing. Okay, so we're gonna quit out of here and minimize that. We're gonna go into our server files here, which we know are working, right? Because we did that. We've got our save files right here, which we know are also working. So we're gonna go ahead and make our single player game. So in order to do that, we gotta get rid of everything here. I know, right? We've done this before 100 times. So we delete all this. This is part of that going back and forth thing that normally you would have done. So you're like, why are you doing all this? Because there are people that have done this already, and I'm just showing them that it works, okay? So we're going to copy everything in here except for this UID data. Don't think you need it. I've tried it without it, and it works fine, so we're going to not need it. If you want to put it in there, it's not going to hurt anything. So we're going to paste that. Boom, there you go. Now we need to go and grab the Nether. Okay, so we're going to go grab the Nether, put that in here. We're going to go grab the end, copy, paste, and put that in there. Okay, so now this is where most of you have been. You've done all this and you start your single player world, and we are going to need this again. So I'm not going to close it. I'm going to minimize that. And we're going to leave that up. We're going to bring our Minecraft back on. And this is the crux of the problem. Okay, right here. This is the crux. So we're going to go to single player world. There's our best world. We're going to open that up. And now, this is the crux. So we've loaded in. The sponges are here. We're in creative mode. The sponges are here. Okay. But we have no netherite armor. We don't have the correct inventory. This is the way it was when we exited the original single player world, right? Because we made changes in the multiplayer world. I told you to remember that. Didn't know there was a test, huh? I said, and we put the sponges over here, the obsidian over here, and we had our flint and steel, and we had netherite armor, and we switched it to survival. We were level 7, if you remember. Okay. Well, none of those things are happening. And this is where most of you guys are at. This is brings us to the meat of the video. Okay, so the meat of the video starts now. Let's go ahead and cancel out of this and save and quit. And we'll go ahead and minimize that. Turn that off for a second. Now, this is where we have to open our best friend Google. So what I need you to do is go to Google. Hi, Google. And I have my Google searching cheat sheet right here, because, you know, cheat sheets are nice. And the first thing we want to do is search for NBT Explorer. Okay, and I will have these, not the links to where you're going to get these, but I'll have the links to what you're supposed to search, because I don't like to give links, because I don't know, links change, people die, things happen. Let's not, you know, run the risk, okay? So NBT Explorer, and when you do that, the very first link that pops up is the link you want. It's a GitHub. Okay, this is where people get really nervous. They're like, I don't want to do this. Well, then don't, okay? This is the meat of the video, though. You're going to go ahead and right-click and download Save As the zip file right here, NBT Explorer zip. That's what I already have on my desktop right here, so I'm not going to re-download it because what a waste. All right? What you're going to do is you can look in here, you know, virus scan it, whatever you need to do. You know, buy it, don't buy it. It's up to you. And then what you're going to do is, what I like to do is right-click, extract files. And when it does that, it gives you the option of how you want to extract it, okay? And when you do that, you can just make the folder, which I did. It's right here. and we're just going to open up the NBT Explorer folder. Okay, this is really simple so far. We're not to the hard stuff yet, guys. We're definitely not to the hard stuff yet. All right. Now, what I need you to do is open up your mbtexplorer.exe. There's two exe files here. Don't be confused. MBT utility, all that's going to do is open a command window, and then it's going to close it immediately. The mbtexplorer.exe is what you want. Okay, so let's open that. It's going to ask you to run it. I do want to run it. And then you're going to get this. Now, MBT Explorer, we're going to make this a little bigger so you guys can see. Well, maybe not see. I don't know. Just so that we're not confused on what's going on here. And actually, I guess I should minimize these and move those out of the way. There we go. So the thing about MBT Explorer is, just to give you an idea of what it is, it's a program, it's a file ripper, if you will. It opens up data files. It's very similar to, like, if you were modding GTA 5 or something, or one of those games that have data files that you have to open. You need this in order to open the data file that we're going to delete. So that's why. But I want to show you why this is failing. So this is why it fails and also why it works. So you come in here and you find your saves. If you don't start with your save folder here, you can go to File, Open Folder, and then navigate to your save folder. It'll be in your app data roaming dot Minecraft saves. You go in there, you find it, you get your saves. Go find the world that you're working on, in our case, best world, because it's the best world. Open that up with the little plus, and then you'll see down here, there's something called player data. Now, most of you that have tried to fix this on your own, opened up your save folder, saw player data, and were like, oh, I'll just delete it and copy over my multiplayer stuff, okay? Because in your multiplayer folder, you also have a player data right here, and that's your player data right there. And you've noticed it doesn't work. Obviously it doesn't work because we just showed it didn't work, okay? So with that said, you're like, well, why isn't this working? It doesn't make sense. The reason it doesn't work is exactly thus. Right here in level.dat, this is why you need MBT Explorer. Open that, you'll see data, however many entries it has, it'll be different for you. Open that data, and right down here, you'll see something called player. This is the single player data for the person who created this world. This is why some of you have not had a problem with this and some of you had. Because if you are the person that made the single player world, then you load back in. It will know. Minecraft knows it's you. Now, some of you have gotten a really weird glitch. I wouldn't even call it a glitch. I think it's working as intended. Where Minecraft overwrites who you are with whoever did open the single player world, and you're like, why do I have an iron sword? I clearly had a diamond sword, and I never was in the game otherwise. So this is what Minecraft will look to overwrite whatever data is in the player data folder when it goes back to single player, okay? And down here is our proof. So we open that up, and you go see you got inventory. Open inventory, and right here, there's our birch log, there's our oak leaves, and there's all of our stuff, right? From the single player world. From the single player world. Okay, so that's why. This is the problem. This is also what we're going to delete to fix the problem. So the first thing you're going to want to do, and incidentally, these things are called compound tags, okay? So when you're doing this, you can actually make these. You can do this. This is a really powerful program if you're really interested in using it. But we're going to do this really simple thing. Player, come up here, and it'll say delete tag. That's what you want to do. You can't right-click and delete it. There's no right-click and delete. You can delete it this way, but I find it's just easier to highlight the one you want to delete. Go up here to delete tag. Press delete tag. It's gone. It's gone. The default player is gone. So if you didn't want to do that with your default player, you're gone. So there you go. All right, but no, that's good. You wanted it gone. All right, so you close that out, and now come back up here, and you see we've got player data right here. All right, so this is something we're gonna need to do. And actually, we're done with MBT Explorer, so you're gonna wanna save this, okay? And then we're gonna minimize this. I'm gonna show you one other thing after this, because you guys are gonna really flip when you see this. So what you would normally do is go into your player data folder, and you're like, okay, yeah, let me copy over my player data now. Well, here's the problem. Let's go under our openish world, which we've seen this before if you followed other my videos. Some of you have player data that looks like this in your servers. These are all the people that joined your server. And you're like, oh, which one is me? I don't know. That is why you need this next search right here, okay? So we're gonna go back into Uncle Google here, because Uncle Google knows all. And we're gonna come here, and we're gonna go ahead and type in MCUUID, all right, MCUUID. And now you're gonna go ahead and click enter. And the very first thing that pops up is this very awesome online tool that finds your UUID in Minecraft. All right, this is a great tool. I use this all the time. I've got it bookmarked. I love this thing. So you type in the username, all right, your username. Mine is PhoenixTalon42. Everybody knows that. And you do lookup. Boom, there it is. There it is. It's right there. That's the UUID for me. So now what I do, now that I know that's my UUID, I can come in here and I can find the 9Delta28, all right? That is me right there, okay, on my server. All right, on my old server, the one that we've already done a video for. Okay, and there I am right there, 9Delta28. So if you know, these are unique IDs to the player, okay? Okay, so when you look in here, you'll see that all these, you know, files are in here, and that's fine. That's good. You know, that's what you want. It has your information in it. That's good. So we're done with this, but I just wanted to show you what it looks like if you have a lot of them or if you just have a couple of them, okay? And that's how you find you, okay, is that UUID number. So we've already saved in here. We don't need this anymore, so I am going to close it. That's fine. And then we're going to go ahead and open these folders back up. And this is my server player data. The server player data has not changed. This is my actual player data over here that I have on this one. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete the player data that Minecraft generated for me from the default data from the single player. And now I'm gonna copy this back over, all right? I'm gonna copy both the data and the old. All right, if you don't have an old, that's fine. Just do the one data that you do have. But if you have a data and an old, this is why we didn't copy this over from NBT Explorer, because it doesn't always show this. All right, but if you have data file and data.old or underscore old, then use both. If not, then just use the one, okay? There might be a little jankiness with that, like depending on when the last time you opened your inventory was, and a couple other little things, there might be some problems, but it's gonna be minimal and you'll have all your stuff back, okay? That's the important thing. All right, so we're gonna go and copy that over. I don't need the server files anymore. We're done with that. And we're gonna go back into Minecraft. And what's gonna happen is now that we don't have a default single player data, when we go, here, let me see this. All right, so when we go back into our single player world, because we don't have a default data, it's gonna overwrite our default data with this server data, and then it's going to give us all that stuff back. And if you look, we got all of our stuff back. Full netherite armor, sponge, obsidian, stack of each, flint and steel, level 7, and in survival, go back to the nether, and let's not die, because they're not gonna like us. Real quick, there's the sponges, there's our inverted tree. We're going back so we don't get killed, because that would be embarrassing. We die in this video. And that's it. I mean, that is literally it, guys. Not hard, not difficult, but it can be if you don't know the path. Now, last thing, just to prove that this is good, last thing, just to prove this is all good. I did say we were done with NBT Explorer. However, I do want to show you that it did overwrite that data. So you're not like, oh, where'd my data go? Okay, so we're just going to go real quick, best world, level.data, open this a little bit more. All right. And player, there it is right there. That's our player, all right? So just so you know, it did overwrite it, it's back, it's good. So now you could theoretically convert this back to a multiplayer world if you want to, now knowing how to convert it back to single player if you also want to, okay? But that's literally the video, guys. So I wanted to thank you all again for the amazing support that you've shown and for your patience with understanding with comments. And I hope this answers a lot of those questions. Again, this isn't going to work for things like with plugins or mods. You can try it with the plugins, but I don't know. It depends on how it influenced your multiplayer world. It also depends on how it influences your single player world. Mods, totally different animal, not even touching that subject, okay? I don't play with a lot of server mods that go back to single player. Usually if it's server, I will run it as a server on my desktop just to ensure that it all still works. So that's how I do it. If it is a single player, usually converting it to server is much easier. That's how I usually build my servers, is I build them in single player, convert to multiplayer, but I don't ever go back, okay? There, it's just not a good idea. But if you want to do it and you know what you're doing, more power to you. That's how you get your inventory back, though, okay? So I hope this was helpful. I'm sorry it's long, but it's necessary to get over all the things. And until the next video, thanks for watching. Peace.